Breaking news out of the US now. Donald Trump's last remaining rival, Nikki Haley, has this morning dropped out of the presidential race. Straight to US correspondent Alison Petrowski. Ali, good morning. It comes after Trump dominated Super Tuesday.
Yeah, that's right. Good morning to you, Brooke. 244 days to the general election here in America now knows its options. Donald Trump with some resounding victories over Nikki Haley yesterday on Super Tuesday, defeating her in all states bar one. And we saw a very gracious Nikki Haley with a concession speech this morning. She said that she had a lot of gratitude for her supporters, Brooke, that she had no regrets and that she would continue campaigning for issues that were important to her. She quoted Margaret Thatcher and said she would not be following the crowd, Brooke, and with that she did not endorse Donald Trump for president.
I congratulate him and wish him well. I wish anyone well who would be America's president. It is now up to Donald Trump to earn the votes of those in our party and beyond it who did not support him. And I hope he does that.
The Republican National Committee, the RNC, this morning has declared that Donald Trump is their presumptive nominee. Donald Trump has reached out to Nikki Haley's supporters, telling them to come and join the greatest political movement in our nation. Current US President Joe Biden has also reached out to Nikki Haley's followers, saying, "I want to be clear, there is a place for them in my campaign. I know there is a lot we won't agree on. I hope and believe we can find common ground." So, look, a feeling of deja vu this morning, Brooke. The 2024 race will come down to Donald Trump and Joe Biden. It is the seventh presidential rematch in US history, the first since the 50s, Brooke, and only once has a former president lost an election only to return for a second term 4 years later. Brooke.
All right. Thanks, Ali.